The Lord Christ greets you. This is your Master Apostle Reddick with Converting Souls Apostolic Ministries. And tonight we are having our spirit-led intercession and supplication. And normally Master Prophet Pastor King is with us, but she is not with us tonight. And so we will begin prayer. I have Evangelist Reed online, along with myself. And if she would like to pray, she can. Or I will just pray the full half hour today. So let us begin. The song I was just playing, God... All my life, he's been faithful. All my life, he's been so, so good. And I want you to understand that whether in the good times or the bad times with God, he is always good. We may not understand why he allows what he allows, but on the bad times, it's not the time to leave him. It's the time to stay with him. The good times, you want to stay with him and you want to praise him and you want to worship him. But during the bad times, you want to leave him. Don't leave him. That's the time to cling to him, to cling to his word, and to understand how good he is even during the good times. And we may not understand it. Our mind can't comprehend it. And I teach you times where Christ had to go to God in hard times. He thought he was forsaken. He wept. But there were times that Christ also said to the Father and give him praise. So whether good or bad, we must stay with the Lord. He is good during it all. I'm going to be reading from the book of Psalms. Chapter 103, starting at verse 1. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Who forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeems thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfy thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagles. And I want you to understand that the Lord executed righteousness. And judgment for all that are oppressed. He made known his ways unto Moses, his acts unto the children of Israel. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and plenteous in mercy. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We just bless your name right now. Thank you for joining us, Prophetess Broadway. Any prayer requests before I begin? Heavenly Father, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to your holy name. Glory to your name, Lord. We bless you this evening. We praise you and we magnify you, Lord. You are worthy of all praise, glory, and honor, and we bless your name. We give you the praise, Lord. Holy and righteous is your name. You are our Redeemer. You redeem our life from destruction. Your loving kindness is always with us. And we give you praise, Lord. We honor you, Father. There is none like you in all the earth. And Father, we pray, thanking Jesus, the living Lamb, for going through the will of God for us, his death and resurrection. We thank you for rising that we may live, that we may be reconciled to God. Thank you for eternal life and the author of eternal salvation. Father, we just give you the praise right now. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you for the less fortunate right now. We ask you, Father, in the name of Jesus, to provide for them shelter, a home, the basic needs. And although the poor may be with us always, you still provide. And you change their lives. Father, I pray that you will provide them with food that they need, shelter, a ear. Sometimes the less fortunate need an ear. I pray that you will meet them where their basic needs can be complete and their spiritual needs. sometimes seeds are planted and Father, they need a little watering, and sometimes they need some more planting. But work out those things in her life, starting with her body, that she may glorify you, that she may give you the praise and the honor due unto your name. I pray that you will continue to move through those of faith that believe in healings and miracles, that you have given the spirit of grace for the gift of faith as we operate through your kingdom in the earth today. Father, I pray that you will continually move by your spirit. Baptize those that is looking for, has been seeking you for baptism. Baptize those, convert their souls that they may strengthen their brother and sisters, God. We're not looking for fake conversion. We're looking for the true conversion. True conversion, Lord. Where out of our bellies we shall flow. Out of our bellies shall flow rivers of living water to profit all. We're looking for the rivers to flow. I pray that those that are ready, that are seeking, that you have given this grace gift, begin to flow in the gift of tongues. And those that are seeking the interpretation, that you would grant it to them. Father, I pray for those that want to grow stronger in you. Strengthen them by your spirit in the inner man. Give them the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of you. Increase in them love and judgment. Love and judgment that they, that we, increase in me too, that we may prove the things that are excellent. Because you are excellent, and anything, any person that you work through will work in excellence. They prove what you want in the earth. They prove what's of you and what's not of you. They prove the things that are excellent. And when we talk about excellence, we're not talking about natural excellence. We're talking about spiritual excellence in your presence, living your word, carrying, proving that which you have approved, making more excellent. So have your way with your vessels of royal diadem at CSAM, Converting Souls Apostolic Ministries. Have your way with those that are calling themselves by your name, other believers. Perfect us, Father. We don't argue perfection by you, because it's your word. It's the purpose of the fivefold ministry to perfect the saints, those that believe in Jesus Christ, to exhort us, to build us up to edification. That we may give forth the praises We are your lively stones in the earth. And Father, we just give you the glory and the honor right now. And we continually pray for those that believe and those that you are calling into the sheepfold that are not yet here. Father, draw them with your spirit. Draw them as we lift up Jesus and teach the sound doctrine that keeps us healthy and that keeps all men healthy, that puts us on a path to reconciliation. So, Father, we just thank you this evening for this time of prayer, of interceding, that you would continue to move by your spirit in America, that the government will listen to that which is sound for America. That which is true, that which is just, that which is right. For Americans. I continue to ask you to pull down the strongholds that cause us to stumble, to fall, the sin that so easily beset us. Pull down the strongholds in our lives that will cause us to turn to the left or to the right, which is called being tossed. Strengthen us by your word. Strengthen us by your spirit. Strengthen us in our inner man. We give you the praise, the glory, and the honor for it, God. You are holy and righteous and just. And there is no other God beside thee. Continue to remove the coverings that are not like you in our lives. Remove the coverings that will cause us to fall, to stumble at your word. Remove the coverings that will keep us in temptations of the evil one. That you told us to pray, Lord, lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil. So, Father, I pray that you will remove the covering that will keep the evil in our path, that will keep us tempted to sin. And I pray that you will strengthen us so that those times of temptation, those times of evil temptations, we can say no. We can be overcomers. That's why they need to be removed until we're strengthened to the place where we can say no. That we will not avoid temptations, but overcome temptations, because that's what your word says. We are overcomers, and we trust and believe in your word. Your word is truth. Jesus is the truth. Help us, groom us in the way that we can do nothing outside the truth, but for the truth. Have your way, God. Holy and righteous is your name. Father, we glorify you and magnify you. We pray for those that are not seeing. They don't have eternal salvation. They refuse in your gift of grace in Jesus Christ. Your Son, your beloved Son. They reject your spirit of grace. Father, I pray for those that need direction and instruction. Not from everybody. Help them to follow your voice, to know whose voice to follow. To know what is sound advice. Advice that is good for them to follow. Help them to choose the sound over the unsound. The good over the bad. The healthy over the unhealthy. In doctrine and teachings and in counsel. Help us to seek your face, that we may know your voice and perceive your message and perceive your sound. Help us that we may grow thereby and know how to follow you and how to follow our leaders, even as the Apostle Paul said, follow me as I follow Christ. And when it's not like Christ, don't attach to it. Don't follow the same behavior. Don't follow the same methods. Don't follow that which is not of you. Not of your Son, Jesus Christ. And I'm not, in this prayer, it's not about leaving a church or leaving a people. When I say don't follow, it is about if your leader is in sin, you don't do the sin. If it's not of Christ, you don't do it. Help us to see it clear. Help us to stand on your word. Help us to move in your kingdom in the earth. Help us to strengthen one another, and that you may be glorified, and that Jesus is lifted up, the Son is revealed. Have your way, Father, and be glorified. Be glorified, Lord. For there is none like you in all the earth. And we just bless your holy name right now. We magnify you and we say hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Sayeredede sikisian sayeredisia. Help us to seek your face, Lord. Day in and day out. At least give you 24 minutes of our day. Help us to seek. Thank you. need to change into your image or into your son's image. Give them the virtue that they need, that they, as they walk in this earth, will look like Christ. Have your way, Lord, and be glorified. Have your way, God, and be praised and high and lifted up. And this we pray in Christ Jesus' name, the Potentate King, the Everlasting Father, the one you call God, equal to yourself, both Lord and Christ. Amen and amen. Amen and amen.